Today I have another book of the month unboxing. This is for the month of November, so let's check it out and see what's inside. As always, I chose one of the book of the month options and I also added on two add-ons. So here we go. Look at that. And the first book at the very top, this is my book of the month choice called The Family. The Family is a historical fiction, and the quick take is set in mid-century Brooklyn, a story of a decades-long friendship between two women bound by the sins of their fathers. So this one just seems super interesting, so I can't wait to dive into it. Every month, Book of the Month gives you 5 books to choose from, so you can choose one of the books, or if nothing seems interesting to you, you can skip that month. But I chose The Family this month, and the other choices were A Little Hope by Ethan Joella, and that is a contemporary fiction. The Keeper of the Night, and that is by Kylie Lee Baker, and that is a young adult book. A thriller called The Collective by Allison Galen. The last one is a romance novel called How to Marry Keanu Reeves in 90 Days, and that is by K.M. Jackson. Let me know in the comments below which book you chose and if you recommend it so I can maybe choose it later as an add-on. In addition to the book of the month, I added on 2 add-ons. And the first one's actually a romance novel, which is not normally the genre I go for. But I heard so many people talking about this one online, how much they loved it. So I thought I would give it a try. And it is The Love Hypothesis by Allie Hazelwood. The quick take on this one is after a fake relationship generates real sparks, a rising scientist must decide if she's ready to experiment with love. My last add-on for the month is called Daisy Jones and the Six, and this is by Taylor Jenkins Reid. Now, I read Malibu Rising. I believe that was the June book of the month I chose. It was pretty good, not my favorite of the year, but then I also read by the same author later, Evelyn, The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. And although it was not one of the books of the month choices for this year, I chose it as an add-on. It was probably the best book I've read all year. I love that book so much. So if I could only recommend one book this month to you guys to go run and read, it would be The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. This was also voted the book of the year for 2019. So again, I cannot wait to read this one. Speaking of the book of the year, they have already come out with all of the book of the year finalists, and I've actually read all of them. At the very bottom of the box, we have my favorite part, the bookmark. And this month it says, Life is Hard Covers. So I love that. I love these bookmarks. I also real quick wanted to go over my October books of the month and let you know what I thought about those. The first book I read in October for my book of the month box was Beautiful World, Where Are You? By Sally Rooney. And I'll be honest, this was not one of my favorite books. I just don't think I'm a Sally Rooney fan. It's just not for me. I also read her book a few months ago, Normal People, and I wasn't loving that one either. So Sally Rooney is just not personally one of my favorite authors, but I know people love her books. So if you did love Normal People, you'll probably love Beautiful World, Where Are You? It was enjoyable, just not one of my favorites from the year. The next book I read for the month of October was The Lincoln Highway, and I love this book so much. I was definitely intimidated. It has 576 pages. And it did take a while to get through this one, but it was worth every minute, every twist and turn. The characters were amazing. So many great characters, so many twists and turns. I loved the time period. I loved the locations. Just everything was written so beautifully, so vividly, just full of action, just always something happening. Such a great book. Highly recommend this one. Let me know in the comments below if you chose this one, what you thought about it, if you loved it as much as I did. The last book I read for the month of October was Razorblade Tears by S.A. Cosby. This is one of the contenders as well for Book of the Year, and I completely understand why. This was such a great book. One thing I did not love about this book is there was a lot of violence, and there was a lot of detailed writing about the fights and the shooting and the blood and the gore. I completely understand it was necessary for the storytelling of this book, but that's just kind of not my cup of tea. I kind of skimmed through all of the violent writing, but aside from that, which again was necessary to the story, Beautiful story, so good. I think I would recommend this book to everyone. It gives you such a great perspective. I loved it. The story follows these two fathers. Their sons were married to each other and they were killed, and the police kind of dropped the ball. They were not investigating their murder anymore. So the dads got together and decided to figure it out on their own. So I love this one. Not my vote for the book of the year, but I definitely can see how it is a finalist, and I would love to read more books by S.A. Cosby. That was everything in my November Book of the Month box. If you are interested in Book of the Month, I will have a coupon code in the description below. I believe right now the deal is you can get your first book for only $5, so be sure to check out that in the description below. It is a subscription box, so you will have to cancel after the first book if you do not want to continue to pay for and receive the books every month after that. But I'll be honest with you, this is the best subscription box I've done this year. I never would have read these books, these life-changing books, if I had not signed up for Book of the Month. I never would have chosen a 576-page book. And I am so glad. This was such a fun journey. Just all of the books that I have read this year have been amazing. So they haven't all been amazing, but it's just been such a fun ride. So I highly recommend it. If you do have any questions about the subscription service, please leave those in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe.